This area is restricted to senior level staff only. If you do not have the proper authorization, please leave immediately. It's for your own good.
And I believe you.
Crazy.
What was that? Freezy? Easy? Breezy? I think I heard him. That looks familiar. It's his house. Are you doing? I have still no zoom function, unfortunately. This is where he was, wasn't it? Oops, sorry. It's not a Half-Life 2 mod if I don't accidentally swing at a computer screen or shoot a wall or something. What is this? I can hear the elevator. They're on their way down here. I just hope the whole thing won't break the moment I start it. I can hear the door. They're here. I just have to... Well, maybe you shouldn't be typing in the first place. I'm finally here. Never Lose Hope Hospital. It's been a while. It feels like everyone is looking at me, like they all know what happened, what I did. I made so many mistakes, and now she wants me to pay for what I've done. I am out of options. I can't go back. I have to hide here. I have heard that there's a new patient coming in, someone they've brought from the woods up north. Apparently they found him next to his crashed car. Everything around him is burnt to the ground, yet he survived the flames. I hope my suspicions are wrong. I was right. That new patient, he came from where I was afraid of. It's no coincidence. She knows I'm here. I've taken shelter in the storage area under the hospital. No one comes down here anyway. I should be safe here. No one is looking for me anyway, except her. I was able to bring some of my work with me when I came here. I just can't stop thinking about it, even though I don't want to. There's a few pages here, I am definitely going to read all of it. Even though I don't want to, my mind keeps working on it. I feel like there's no turning back now. This will protect me from her. I can't make any mistakes, not again. Been hearing things, can barely sleep anymore. I feel like I've been here for so long, I can't remember the last time I saw the sun. I can feel her, she's haunting me. I can't take this anymore. There is no other way. I have to defend myself, I have to keep her away. I'm turning it on. What have I done? Everyone's dead. They knew I was down here. It was self-defense. The hospital's empty. Everyone is either long gone or dead. Except for that one patient. It didn't affect him. It must be her. It's interesting. It's been so quiet for such a long time. It's just me and him down here. I can watch him in his cell through the hospital CCTV. He's been in a coma since he arrived. He seems to move every once in a while. It's her. She's preparing him, waiting for the perfect moment to act. I can't let her do it. Okay, so I was kinda right. I couldn't wait anymore. I tried to get rid of him. I took a fire axe and went to the cells to finish this. The second I opened the door, I felt a chill down my spine. It was her. I couldn't do it. Not like this. I turned around and started heading back. I took a detour through the cafeteria to get some food. Good thing I had the fire axe with me because Joe was still around the kitchen. What was left of him was trying to attack me, but I managed to nail him to the floor. He was a terrible chef anyway. The core is finished. I'm ready to face her. No more waiting games. This ends tonight. I'll do the first move. I am waking him up. Okay. It worked. He's up and about. I need to get him closer to me where I'll have the higher ground. Crap, somebody must have detected the core's initial pulse. It's only been an hour and I can already hear a helicopter outside. My god, what did I get myself into? You gotta be kidding me. They've sent SWAT in. I'm deep shit now. The soldiers are not the real issue. Using the core, I can take them out one by one, but the helicopter, it's just out of the core's range. One wrong move and it flies away, only to return with a freaking army. I've got to plan this out. I've got it. The radio tower. If I could disable the hospital radio equipment, I'd be able to use the tower to boost the core's range. Ugh, I can't go there on my own, it's too risky. But I think I got the perfect man for the job, you son of a bitch. It is done. The helicopter is out of the picture and so are the SWAT, but him, no matter what I do, he just won't die. It's her. She's keeping alive. She's keeping him alive, no matter what. He's coming. She's with him. I gave him a chance to leave, but she won't allow him to. I have to prepare for the worst. The core is fully operational, but unstable. Let's hope the wooden planks I've used as support beams will be enough. That's all I could do in such a little time. I think I can win this. She can't get too close. That's why I built the whole thing in the first place. Huh. I can hear the elevator. They're on their way down here. I just hope the whole thing won't break the moment I start it. I can hear the door there. Here, I just have to... Right. Wow. So. Wow, that really has made it all come together. He did something. He invented something, I suppose, at that house. Or at least, you know, he never said so much, but that's what was implied. He invented something at that house. And... Or whatever he did. I think it caused the death of maybe his daughter or somebody like somebody as such or a girl, whatever happened, but I think probably his daughter, and she has been angry ever since, haunting the nightmare house, maybe like living with the zombies which the core created in the first place when he first set it up. And then I came by, stupid, drunk, driving, crashed into a tree. I deserve this! I came by and got infected, basically, like possessed. By coincidence, or by direction from her, I came here. Like, maybe she knew that he would be here, maybe it was just coincidence. I forget why he said that he'd come in. Never Lose Hope Hospital. Yeah. So he had some past here, so it's not out of the question that she would have known it as well. She took me here to look for him. He knew that she was here, so activated the core. The core made the zombies. Possibly. Or perhaps the core just made everybody dead. Regardless, if... Maybe that doesn't quite sit right. I feel like the core made the zombies, because I don't think that she wants me dead. She's been wimpy this whole time, and dropping me through floors and stuff like that, and scaring the ever-loving crap out of me. And yes, sometimes she's connected to zombie encounters, but not all the time. The zombies are, I think, a separate thing. I hope you don't mind me recapping on the plot here. I appreciate that I could be moving forward, but I just want to make this all clear. That... So she's separate from the zombies. The zombies trying to kill me just because they're zombies. They're not under this guy's control either, even though he does want me dead, because if I die, then she will lose power, I'm guessing. And now he gave me that one chance to leave. He gave up on killing me, just trying to get me to take her away. Last gasp ditch effort to survive, and it seems like all he cares about is survival. I don't know what exactly it is that he's doing or what this work is worth. But at the moment, this journal just suggests that he wants to not be killed by her. But if I take the core down, if I confront him and take the core down, she will kill him, he will die, the core will go down, zombies will stop rising, and maybe she'll be at peace. That's my light at the end of the tunnel. Excellent. I will say that, this is great. Like, this is fully booted me into the story. But sorry. but I'm afraid that until now I wasn't really with it because I didn't expect to be able to ever win. It didn't seem like I was able to ever win because there were either zombies or her who seemed to have control of the very fabric of reality. There didn't seem to be a light at the end of the tunnel. It would just be like horror movie moment without any real sort of story substance or objective I would be working towards to try and see the light at the end of the tunnel. But now I see it. And I am firmly for it, so let's go. Okay, that way. But of course, being me, oh, I can't go down that way. Did I just come this way? I did. Yes, I did. Okay. How about this? No, not that way. Dr. Romero, or whatever your name is. Dear Doctor, I'm sorry, you don't seem like a truly bad person. But you also did all this. And if I have to take you down to get out of it, then that is what I'll do. Wooden support beams holding up the core, you say? How fortunate, I have the antidote. Oh, for goodness sake. I think, thinking these boards, are they necessary? Like, do I need them for this? But they're just there to remind me that I can take apart wood with my tomahawk. What are you? Well,
this is the core, my life's long work. It's beautiful, isn't it?
Well, yes.
It's important to me, and I'll go as far as needed in order to achieve my goals. I've made some mistakes, sacrifices, my loved one, and even I myself, but I have to continue. There is no turning back now. I'm afraid I can't let you interfere. It's protecting me, you see, keeping me safe from her. Therefore, I have to send a few friends to keep you company.
Oh, fuck.
Let's see how long you can last against them. That's always a great experiment.
Yeah, you're far off the deep end, dude. Oh, fuck these guys.
What the hell are you doing? Well, even with 50% of the power, the core is still fully functional. I didn't need that shield anyway. I have a lot of other surprises for you.
I have a tomahawk.
All right. I actually wasn't planning on using the pulse emitters, but you're leaving me no choice.
What?
Enjoy.
What?
Hey, watch out. Support me for the crash. How'd you like that? Hell, even my head hurts a little bit from up here. Just let me recharge for a bit, and I'll make sure you get hit right again.
That hurts a bit. It's not super strenuous. She'd get in here. Come on. Oh, fuck. Depends on how close I am, I think. Whoa.
I wonder what this switch does. Whoops.
Girl, if you want to actually, help me with this, then that would be great.
I can do this all day.
You'd be surprised. Oh god, I'm trapped! Oh shit! So that's what you do.
So. God, I wish I had a problem.
You're like sociopathic levels of emotionally dead. Nope.
I am going to kick your ass. With science, of course.
Cool. I'm game for it. I'm running out of health. Health.
Are you having fun?
Not really. Well, I mean, yes, I'm playing a game, but... Oh god, there's too many support beams. Okay, hang on. Can I, Can I just hack into these? Do they go? I think so. Beg, I get, keep getting stuck on the body. Oh god. They're so confusing. Fuck these guys. Is that doing anything?
What are you doing?
It's working, but it's a long, hard slog. Okay, I need to use this time to get health. Okay, I mean, do I focus up? Whoa. Shit. Good. Oh boy. Nope, don't die. Six health. I want to kill this thing so bad. Get in there.
Seriously, get the hell away from the support beams.
Shan't.
If you don't stop this immediately, I'll make your nightmare much worse.
What are you threatening me with, dude? You're already gonna kill me. Shit, don't. Damn it. I really am at wit's end here. No, I'm not. I have a bit more health. In fact, there's more in here. Can I just... Where'd he go? Where did he go? There he is. Shotgun's actually really effective against us, but I'm sort of running out of bullets. Hang on. There we go!
What the hell are you doing? The support beams are all that's holding the core up in the air!
You really are mad, aren't you?
I'm not gonna let you keep doing that. Time to send you somewhere else. Into your own head. Bon voyage.
Wait, what? Hang on, no, don't please. Oh, great. Wonderful. She is here.
Stop it! You can't even imagine what will happen if this whole thing falls.
We die? I'm already about to die. I just turned you off. Get the barrier down. Whoa. Let's just switch over to the SMG instead.
Oh, you haven't had enough yet? Alright.
Okay, hang on. I'm pretty closely dismantling each and every one of these.
Swear to God, you don't stop getting more.
The core is the only thing stopping her from getting here. You can't destroy it.
It's already here, you just don't know it yet.
Well, good night.
Whoa. Doors. I'm becoming familiar with their work. Ah. Trapped. So wait, this stuff, is this you as well? Was she just rescuing it me from it each time? Here we go. I have my target. Oh hell. More mannequins. I'm now wondering like how much of what I experienced was just you trying to kill me. Oh. Oh fuck. And how much of anything was her? Whoops. Fine then. Again.
No. No, this can't be.
It is her.
You just don't get it, do you?
You think you crashed your car in front of our house by accident and ended up here?
It's not a coincidence. She's using you. You're just a pawn in her game.
Whatever.
A bad person. This whole thing is more complicated than you'll ever understand.
Come on. Ugh, feck.
You shut down the core, she'll be able to come here. You won't be able to stop her.
Missed.
I want to see if she saves you from this one.
Well, where am I? Whoa! No! No! Stop! Car? Did I go to the car? Thanks, babe. Is this what happened?
All the way here?
Don't you understand? It was an accident!
Well, she can't help you now. If she goes to the core anyway. Just give up.
You're
not even helping the situation. Let's go.
One more strut, dude. Good boy. Now. One more strut.
Wow, you have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
Oh, it's not done. It's not done yet. It's almost done, though.
Oh, she can't believe it. Don't think she's helping you or anything. You're nothing but a tool to her.
What do I am to you, a target? What's my options here? Ow.
She's using you to get to me.
Shut up.
Well, what do you know? It's still operative.
Shit.
I guess I won.
Oh, there you go. Enjoy.
Oh, shit. Emily. Emily, my love. It worked. You're back. I'm sorry for everything that's happened. I'm sorry for everything I had to... No! No!
Cool. Okay, credits everybody. Back to the animal. Strange beeps at the end. I don't know. I mean, there was definitely like potential for a sequel in there. The core, it's also dot dot dot, and then beep 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 just there. Beeping maybe means that I survived, and I'm back in yet another hospital. Wow. That was awesome. In the end, as a twist should, it all came together. Even in retrospect, every piece of imagery which is, well, most of them anyway, every piece of imagery which I saw beforehand, every time I got trapped in a strange environment and then she would appear at the very end, learning that she wasn't doing it to scare me, which sort of seemed like the purpose, like the only purpose. Because I assumed that she was responsible. Like, she would just freak me out, and then she'd pull me out at the end. But no, that was actually him trying to properly kill me and entrap me, and her pulling me out of it. That's incredible. What an awesome story by the end of it. That was really cool. Well done. I will admit, this game, for the first hour and a half, maybe even for most of it, failed to grab me. I'm afraid that's just the case. Don't get me wrong, it was well made. Like, it was properly creepy. Well, okay. As I said before in the prologue, I think the girl pulled the appear suddenly in front of you and disappear thing too much. It was in there too often, and I got desensitized to it. And there were so many little, like, creepy just flashes like that. I stopped really reacting to them. They were just something that I noticed now, and they weren't jump scares. So in terms of, because jump scares were happening and they were constructed like jump scares, the only thing which was kind of different from them was their proximity to each other meant that their effectiveness was lessened, because you can't keep running that and not devalue it, and that was sort of what was happening. The game, any bits where the girl would appear behind a pane of glass, or a body would appear suddenly, or yeah, like a corpse would fall from the ceiling, or something would come up, or a piece of furniture would fall over. By the end of it, like, completely not reacted to it. I mean, they, for the record, and maybe this was the intended effect, they did have the effect of keeping me on edge and making me feel like I was constantly being followed. But when the game set aside scenes, like the mannequin bit, which is maybe like one of the most memorable bits for me, or when the claustrophobia bits too, which we now realise is just a thing which that core can do to people, just trapping them inside a vision and then just getting smaller and smaller, and presumably the end result either trapping them in there forever or crushing them. Yeah, those were good. The one-offs like that, where they took, like, not just a second of your time, but, like, a couple minutes of your time to, like, do something scary, those were when it really came to life for me. Those were the actual bits that were scary. And, like, yeah, this was a scary game in general. Huh. I want to talk about all of that. I think, where do I want to start with it? I've already spoken a little bit about the story. I think I've covered the story basically from what I've already said. But a lot of it has, a lot of what the story does affects the way that you look at a horror. For me, a horror needs to have a story. For the most part, I don't mind sort of short, digestible bits which are just kind of like a well-crafted horror thing. I guess that's what it comes down to. I either need an interesting story or an interesting monster. And at the start, I didn't feel like it had either of those things. Because it was a little girl ghost. Now, whilst it was a very well-designed little girl ghost, and she in the end she fit into the plot extremely well, it is also nothing that we haven't seen before, especially when reviewers were drawing comparisons to Fear with this game. Which I suppose are apt, and like, but only with the little girl thing, really. Like, I wasn't fighting soldiers. I was fighting, but I was fighting zombies. I wouldn't necessarily equate it to Fear that much. Okay, some of its scene setups were also fairly similar. Yeah, little girl ghost who would be trapping me in visions, and then pulling me out of them, throwing over furniture. But the only time that she seemed to ever, this is my perspective from the beginning of the game, the only time she ever seemed to actually be trying to kill me was when she sent zombies at me, which made me think, like, okay, what is she doing? Is she just trying to scare me? And then that kind of broke through to me, the player. I was like, wait, is the game just trying to scare me? And it's not really, like, providing me with any substance or reason, or, like, I'm not being provided with a character here, I'm being provided with a means of providing scares. Now, this all turned out to be inaccurate. But I think the game should have maybe, I sort of wish it had anchored that there was maybe a bit more going on at first. I mean, I suspected a little bit, like, the girl would whisper to you every now and then. And you do wonder what he's saying, but she still seems overtly hostile, so you're wondering if that's just meant to be a part of the atmosphere. So yeah, for that reason, for the longest time, because I thought she was the only threat, and because she seemed to control everything, and yeah, I didn't feel grabbed by it. I felt like I was just going through a horror ride, especially with the way that doors would, like, unlock, and like this game started off aggressively linearly. You did everything at very certain points in time, and some games are like that, but some do a better job of disguising it. This one, where it had doors which were locked 1 second and open the next, like, you assume it's the ghost, But because, again, you're assuming it's the ghost, you are under its control, and so you don't feel like you're going down a path that will lead to your release. But if the game had established earlier that we were going somewhere, that there was some hope, even if it was like a red herring or something like that, like a way out, a way to actually defeat the ghost, not just to escape the building, because you still know that she is in control of everything, so you're like, why would escaping the building help? She was with me at Nightmare House, she was with me at this hospital. Escaping the building, that's not going to do anything. So, like, some sort of means of getting rid of that would have been good at the start, I think. But then later on, when it comes together, in maybe like the last 40 minutes, it all makes perfect sense, and you realize that, wow, I'm glad I stuck with this, because it turns out that its story is awesome when you get to the end. So, kudos for that. Like, I criticized it, and I stand by the criticism of the story, but not what the story was, just how it was conveyed. It tricked me into thinking there wasn't a story at first. And I think that's my major problem with the game. A game which I am now sitting here going, that was fucking awesome. My major issue with it was that it didn't grab me for so long. Aside from that, everything else was really good. Like, comparisons to Fear, I suppose, are inevitable because of the little girl thing and the shooter horror genre, and Fear's kind of the classic, but it is quite different. The zombies are very... Do you know what? They're a very unique enemy. Like, there were definitely points in there, like, it still felt like a Source game, but you forget that they are from the Half-Life 2 engine. Like, this felt like a standalone game because they've been really inventive with making the HUD feel different, making the melee combat feel way different than it does in Half-Life 2. Again, I'll draw comparisons to Condemned because that's visually what it looks like and kind of what it feels like too. The zombies were like unique enemies, even when they were using like some character models from the Half-Life universe. Like, it didn't take me long at all to kind of get over that and realize. Well, I mean, obviously, when they switched to the hospital, they kind of dumped the character model of the Half-Life 2 zombies altogether. They used their same animations and their same but they painted over them, and so they felt completely different. Felt like a zombie shooter game. Sometimes the zombies felt like a bit too much like tanks for my liking, but I think that maybe goes towards the kind of like insistent horde-ish, like enemies are really threatening. Killing them is pretty satisfying, but just hitting them without dying, sometimes it feels like I have no idea how much health this guy has left. Like, he just keeps coming at me. Is he gonna die before he gets to me? So there's tension in there, which I suspect was deliberate. I think that was, whilst it did lead to some frustration, I think part of that sense of hopelessness and overwhelmedness is part of the game's intent, and that worked very well. Aside from that, music was really good. Again, I do wonder if it's an original soundtrack. I suspect so. I haven't heard it myself. I don't know if it was made specifically for the game or if it was, you know, purchased from another artist who'd already created it, but it fit very well. Locations were solid, I think. Sometimes there were rooms which I didn't really see the value of going into, like, at all. Like I wasn't really feeling the need to search for... Okay, actually, later on, I was feeling the need to search for ammo. But at the start, there were, like, rooms where there might have been ammo in, and I just kind of felt like I was meleeing my way through problems, so I didn't feel the desire for it. The puzzles were good as well. Like, there weren't many puzzles, but the ones which came up sort of felt pretty natural. I still think that mannequin bit, like... I don't know why I thought of that with puzzles. I think that was just because, like... Yeah, I had to flip a switch, and then... They directed me to flip a switch and then came back. That was weird, actually. Was that the girl pretending to be a mannequin in that case? It could well have been, because he got that SWAT guy that she was pretending to be, or that the doctor was pretending to be, got me through that door. That kind of begs the question of Brainor? Whatever that doctor's name was, what was his intent to kill her? Was he going to use the core? We don't know what the core was for. I doubt it made zombies. I doubt that was its initial intent. Or do you know what? Here's a theory. What if those spindly guys that we saw, All the core does is generate them. They go, they kill, and then when they've killed, they clamber into a body and they infect it. Resident Evil style. They're not dead people brought back to life by some magic or strange thing. They're puppets to one of those things, because we did see them like just spawn from those cores. That's strange. That is interesting. This has turned out to be a really interesting thing. But I don't think I have too much else to say about it. Well done, creators of Nightmare House 2. You have created what turned out in the end to be a really good game. Well done. Hope you go on to do even better stuff in the future. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching, everybody. And I will see you in the next episode of whatever it is I'm playing.